reading from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Philippians. I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine for you, all making request with joy, for your fellowship in furtherance of the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this very thing, that he who hath begun a good work in you will perfect it until the day of Jesus Christ. Even as it is meet for me to think of this of you all, because I have you in my heart, inasmuch as both in my bonds and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel, ye all are partakers with me of grace. For God is my record, how greatly I long after you all in the tender mercies of Jesus Christ. And this I pray, that your love may abound yet more and more in knowledge and in all judgment, that ye may approve things that are excellent, that ye may be sincere and without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ, unto the glory and praise of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. sin against me, and I forgive him till seven times. Jesus said unto him, I say not unto thee until seven times, but until 70 times seven. Therefore is the kingdom of heaven likened unto a certain king, which would take account of his servants. And when he had begun to reckon, one who was brought unto him, which owed him 10,000 talents. But as for as much as he had not to pay, his Lord commanded him to be sold, and his wife and children, and all that he had, and payment to be made. The servant therefore fell down and worshipped him, saying, Lord, have patience with me, and I will pay thee all. Then the Lord of that servant was moved with compassion, and loosed him, and forgave him the debt. But the same servant went out, and found one of his fellow servants, which owed him 100 pence, and he laid hands on him, and took him by the throat, saying, Pay me that thou owest. And his fellow servant fell down at his feet and besought him, saying, Have patience with me, and I will pay thee all. And he would not, but went and cast him into prison till he should pay the debt. So when his fellow servants saw what was done, they were very sorry, and came and told unto their lord all that was done. Then his Lord, after that he called him, said unto him, O thou wicked servant, I forgave thee all that debt because thou desirest me. Shouldest not thou also have had compassion on thy fellow servant, even as I had pity on thee? And his Lord was wroth, and delivered him to the tormentors till he should pay all that was due unto him. So likewise shall my heavenly Father do also unto you, if ye from your hearts forgive not every one his brother their trespasses.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Christian forgiveness can be a very strong witness to the transforming power of the Christian faith. God's forgiveness of us, taught in his ministry and offered on the cross of Jesus Christ, is one of the central themes of Christianity. The Synoptic Gospels' accounts of Jesus' teaching place the practice of forgiveness as an obligation of the Christian. But always when preaching on this, there must be the clear awareness that people, for good reason sometimes, differ in their capacity and readiness to forgive. God, of course, can graciously surprise, but the reality is that forgiveness is a process, and forgiving is often the end, not the beginning, of that process. Also, the process is unique to each. though there are probably some common features. Why forgiveness is incredibly challenging and incredibly empowering is because it is part of an altered pattern of living the Lucan Lord's Prayer. And forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone who is indebted to us. This reflects a shift in power relationships from being controlled to freedom. It's a shift from obligation to a relationship based on freely giving. And here comes the huge challenge. The person who asks forgiveness is a person who has renounced the privilege of being right or safe. They have acknowledged that they are hungry for healing, for the bread of acceptance and restoration to relationship. But equally, the person who forgives has renounced the safety of being locked into the position of the offended victim. He has decided to take the risk of creating afresh a relationship known to be dangerous, even to be capable of causing hurt. Both the giver and the receiver of forgiveness have moved out of the safety zone. They have begun to ask how to receive their humanity back as a gift. It's not easy. Move from a concern for defending my own dignity, rather to a space of being willing to receive it in love. So surely the journey of forgiveness is fragile, because it requires us being reacquainted with our vulnerability, to learn how to approach each other, not only to approach God with our hands open. God, it seems, is often the easier option. The journey of forgiveness cannot be wedded inseparably to our own security and prosperity. And perhaps this explains the Lord's Prayer at once going on from the petition to give us this day our daily bread, to and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive them who trespass against us. To forgive is clearly the mark of a humanity touched by God. Who can forget some of those harrowing images of the truth and reconciliation? Forgiveness is one of the most radical ways in which we are able to nourish one another's humanity. When offense is given and hurt is done, the customary human response is withdrawal, the reinforcing of the walls of the private self. The unforgiving and the unforgiven cannot see the other as someone who is part of God's work of bestowing humanity on them. If we can accept the unwelcome picture of us and our world that Good Friday offers, we are in the strangest way set free to really hear what Easter says. Give up the struggle to be innocent and the hope that God will show that you were right after all and everyone else wrong. Simply ask for whatever healing it is you need, whatever grace and hope you need to be free, and then step towards your neighbor. The resurrection reveals a God who is ready to give you that grace and to walk with you when in our world, as we are faced with the terrible deadlocks of mutual hatred and suspicion, with the rival stories of suffering and atrocity. We have to pray for this resurrection message to be heard. Forgiveness is the exchange of the bread of life and the bread of truth. It is the way in which those who have damaged each other's humanity and denied its dignity are brought back, can be brought back into a relation where each feeds the other and nurtures their dignity. It is a gross distortion of forgiveness that sees it as a sort of claim to power over the other, being a patron or a benefactor towards someone less secure. I choose to forgive you. We should rather think of those extraordinary words in the prophecy of Hosea. How can I give you up, Ephraim? For I am God and not a mortal. To conclude, perhaps Rowan Williams sums it up quite magnificently. The one thing you know for certain about your tiresome, annoying, disobedient, disedifying fellow Christians is that God has welcomed them. That becomes your challenge. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty God, who has taught us to pray for all people and has promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in faith, we beseech thee to look mercifully upon thy universal church and to inspire it with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. We pray especially for the work of the church in this diocese and ask thy blessing on Thabo, our bishop, and Joshua, his suffragan. Lord, in thy mercy. We pray for the needs of those who live in this place and worship in this church. Especially on Bible Sunday, Lord Jesus, we pray for your church as she proclaims your gospel of love and truth. Let all who search the scriptures to find eternal life do so in the light of your wisdom and through your loving and compassionate eyes. Forgive us when we seek to use your word for our own ends and to condemn others. Lord, in thy mercy. We pray for a right stewardship of the world thou hast created. We pray for the nations of the world and for their leaders, that they may minister justice for the maintenance of righteousness and peace. At this time, we pray for all those whose homes have suffered damage in any way as a result of the floods in the Eastern Cape. Surround them, Lord, with your love and protection. We pray too for peace in the Ukraine and in the Middle East. We pray for those elected to public office, both in our own land and throughout our continent, as we say, God bless Africa, guard her children, guide her leaders, and give her peace, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. We beseech you to bless both those whom we love and those for whom we are bound to pray. Lord, in thy mercy. We beseech you of thy goodness to send thy healing grace to all who suffer in body or in soul. Especially we pray for Rian van Wyk, Zenande Ndiki, Norman Brink, Bill Schroeder, Judy Velli, Thomas Tukisi, Sarah Christie, Father Brian Beck, Mel Fryer, Lynn Healy, Jill Wilkinson, Jessica Kruger, and Gradwell Beck. Lord, in thy mercy. We commend to thy gracious keeping all those who have died in faith, especially those whose years mind occur this week. Alistair Kirkland, Neil Fraser, Belinda Harbour, Alida van der Pfeiffer, Valerie Bertold, Wileen Dutoy, Jane Lenny, Edith Williams, Ivy Cornick, Winifred Hutton, Babs van Sale, Margaret Richardson, Alice Forsdyke, and Bernard Schultz. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. We pray for those who will die in our city today, especially those who will die alone and unloved. Lord, in thy mercy. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. We confess to God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed through our own grievous fault. Wherefore we pray God to have mercy upon us.
us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, who with thine only begotten Son and the Holy Ghost art one God, one Lord, in Trinity of persons and in unity of substance, who hast created all things through thy eternal word. Therefore with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, and thanksgiving be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who by his one oblation of himself once offered, made a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Thank you. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, do render unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And, looking for his coming again with power and great glory, we offer here unto thy divine majesty this holy bread of eternal life, this cup of everlasting salvation. And we humbly beseech thee to pour thy Holy Spirit upon us as upon these thy gifts, that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, and be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And we entirely desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we often present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. As our Saviour Jesus Christ hath commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with us.
Thank you.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood. Sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and in us. Amen.
This is the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his Son.
Oh, well, I want to see you now. dear Lord.